Hey everyone, welcome back to my channel. I'm Pritishna and I post videos related to art, paintings and DIYs and many more. All of us like to decorate our homes with some handmade products, right? So, especially if you have something made of your own creativity, nothing can be better than that, right? So, in this particular video, I'm going to show you how you can make a DIY letterbox like this. So, without any further delay, let's get started. For this, we need a cardboard detergent box. Well, this one is of a 2 kg pack. Next, we need some paint brushes. We will also need some white acrylic paint and some other colors, like this is burnt sienna or brown and lemon yellow. The first step we need to do is apply a base coat using white acrylic color. And I would suggest use a larger sized brush, obviously to save time. Okay, now this is optional. I'm adding a matte medium to the white acrylic paint. This is going to give it a matte finish, and if you have it, then only add, or else you don't need it. I'm just adding a few drops to the white acrylic color and spreading it all over the surface. And we need to cover the whole surface of the box with the white acrylic color for a base coat. You can see how I'm doing it. If you have even a larger sized brush, you can use. Now this side is almost done. I will quickly finish this side and we'll move on to the next. We need to follow the same step for all the sides of the box as I am doing here, you can see. And don't leave any side of the box without a base coat. Once application of base coat is done, we need to let it dry completely. Do not touch it before it is dry. For the next step, we will need a flat brush, and now we will make a color that resembles the color of wood. For this, we need to take white color, and again I'm adding matte medium, and this is a personal choice and optional. Next, we will add some burnt sienna to white and also a little bit of lemon yellow, and this is how the color should look like. You can make variation in color by adjusting the amount of burnt sienna and lemon yellow, and we don't need to mix the colors so much, because that way we can get a better shade for wood. And it is absolutely fine if some part looks more whiter and some part looks more darker or brownish. Okay, it's absolutely fine. Now we will add some burnt sienna in some areas randomly. You can see how I'm doing it, and we will blend it. We will continue doing this for the rest of the area of this side. This side is almost done, and after completing one side, I would suggest let it dry and then move to the next side to prevent leaving any fingerprints on the painted side. And also we will make sure that there are no white gaps, and we will repeat the same for all the sides of the box. We need to paint the bottom side of the box as well to make it look like it is made of real wood. Next, once the layer is dry, we will take burnt sienna and draw lines parallel to each other with around 1.5 inches of gap between them, and then blend with 2-3 brush strokes. And if required, we can add a very little amount of black to make the lines darker. This is going to give an effect like the box is made of small wooden planks. We can add some highlights by using the lighter shade of wood color that we earlier made. Lastly, we will do some dry brushing for more realistic effect. Now let it dry completely, and then we will do some decoration using some paper leaves and flowers. We will apply some glue in the shape of a branch. Next, we will stick the paper branch on it. If you are thinking how to do this, here it is. Take a piece of paper about 30 cm long and 1 inch wide, then start to pinch and roll from one end and continue towards the other end. For dividing branches, tear the paper up to some length and follow the same pinch and roll, and you will be done. We will stick it and we will let it dry for some time before going for the next step. You can try this design, or if you have some other creative ideas, you can obviously do that. Next, we will make some paper leaves for our branch. We will take a piece of paper and cut it as shown. We need smaller rectangular pieces of paper to make our leaves. A size of approximately 1 inch in length will be absolutely fine. Once done cutting, we will fold it lengthwise from the middle and cut it to give the shape of a leaf. Next, we will fold it like this for giving it a 3D effect. After unfolding, it will look like this. Now we will stick the leaves to the branch using glue. You can stick them alternately or opposite to one another. We will stick the leaves throughout the length of the branch. And this is how it will look once all the leaves are attached. Okay, I felt the color was a little bit dull, so I painted it using light green and dark green color. This is optional. And next, I have some handmade flowers. We will add some paper flowers of our choice. I have made these, so I'm using them. You can use other flowers that you know and can make some flowers by yourself. And in my next video, I promise I'll share the process how to make these paper flowers. They're super easy, and we will glue the flowers near the leaf nodes. And once the flowers are added, our letterbox is all done. The wooden effect is going to look like this, and this is the final look. Isn't it beautiful? You must give it a try. I hope this video was helpful. If you find it good, then please give it a like, comment down below, share with your friends, and don't forget to subscribe to my channel. And if you think you can recreate this, then please post the pictures on Instagram. My Instagram is right here. Thank you so much for watching.